The word intensity to me can mean a lot of variations, you know? Everybody thinks intensity as taking your pre-workout and coming to the gym and having headphones where it sounds like something's going in there, like some kind of machine noise and guy yelling, screaming. Intensity is lots of things. It's the weight you lift. It's how fast you go. It's how much you rest, how much you don't rest, how many reps you do, how many total sets you do, the volume of work you're doing. It's a million things that involve intensity. Just give it more. More of all those things. You know, I see people that just, a lot of the newer things I see just aren't enough volume. Like Wendler's 5-3-1, for instance. Like I said, I like it. It's great for beginners. Jim Wendler came up with a great plan. Jim's a really smart guy, great trainer, off the cuff, clever dude. But I think he wrote a book that he knew a lot of people would buy because it's easy. You know, and it doesn't quite have the, that I like, when I train somebody to be strong, I like to get them up to a high percentage and keep them up there. You know, me and Ed Cohen talked about this before, and Ed Cohen's one of the greatest powerlifters ever. He's like, I don't know how these guys keep going, you know, 85% of their one rep max and above, and then keep dropping it down and trying to get back up there again. Once you're up there, it's a lot easier to stay up there and keep it moving up from there. You know, keep dropping down. You're always climbing the mountain, you know? You're always coming down the mountain and climbing the mountain. Again, it sounds stupid. It sounds like, oh, you can't do that. Oh, that's too hard. You'll get hurt doing that. But, you know, I talked to old timers, Ken Patera, Bruce Wilhelm, and I asked these guys, you know, were you guys deloading? They're like, pfft, the fuck is that? You know, they laughed. They're like, you can't do that. It goes against everything that strength training is, you know? And I'm like, well, how'd you guys train? Heavy all the time. I said, well, you mean heavy like in a heavy phase? No, heavy all the time.
I had a young guy who was working out with me recently, within the last few years. And I took him through like chest and shoulders or something. And when we were done, he was just completely, he was wasted. He was gone. And he goes, wow. He goes, whew, this is your intensity week, right? I'm like, what the hell are you talking about? He goes, this is intensity week. That's why you're training like that, right? I said, no, I'm just training. This is just how I train. I don't even know what you're talking about with intensity week. Does anyone here know what he meant by that? Is there like cycling of, I don't know. But that's
you
just
have, you have pussy week?
That's just, yeah, I know, yeah.
What's not
like
intensity?
Last week was pussy week? I don't know. That's just how I train. And apparently that was like.
Thank God it's pussy week.
That regular workout was an example of like what would be off the charts.
I think the very last time me and you worked him. Out was probably your down at the training center. And you go, look, we're not gonna kill each other, right? We're not gonna train
that
like
never
you
works.
And I'm like, right. I'm like, I know what this means. I'm going to drink extra water and eat a lot of food.
Whenever we promise each other we're not going to kill each other.
We're just going to do a simple, you know, easy workout. It's like a simple, easy workout.
That's the kiss
of death.
Nobody in the
room could have finished. Like, it was like, so hard. And I'm like, you dick. Mm-hmm. I do that to my training partners all the time. I test them. Like, there's a couple guys I train with more so on a regular basis. And I'll text them the night before, we should just probably take an easy day tomorrow. What do you think? And they go,
as soon as you say that.
They go, yeah, man. I'm like, wrong. You failed the test already, you dick. I'm going to hammer you into the ground tomorrow. I don't know why they think all of a sudden I'm going to say, let's take it easy today. I never do that. You know, like, I don't know why they think that.
They figure it's worth a try.
This is why, and this happens to a lot of people that I've trained over the years and I've talked to over the years, is like, man, the squats are going great. The benches are going great. Deadlifts is kind of in the shitter. And I tell people, back off of it. Just back away from it for deadlift every 3 weeks.
Seems to me like they're the most systemically challenging.
Yeah, they really seem to be. And they get into your head a lot more. And I think that's the main problem. It's more of a mental problem. Remember, there's always three basic causes of a lifting problem. It's either mental, physical, or mechanical. In this case, I think it's more mental than anything else. I've seen you deadlift. Mechanically, you know, your technique looks pretty crisp. You know, physically, you're not hurt most of the time. So I think it's just what it is you're getting in your head too much. You know, you feel comfortable with your squats, you feel comfortable with your benching, your deadlift, it's obviously a focus in your mind. You're coming to the gym already nervous about your deadlift. It's not gonna work that way. Deadlift is that one lift where you've gotta be in the right frame of mind. It's different than the other lifts. You're not reacting. When you squat, you're reacting to that bar coming down. You're forced to react to the bottom. Bench press, the same thing. The deadlift is just standing there, it's laughing at you, you know, and it's getting in your head too much. Yep. You gotta own that bar when you deadlift, and you gotta really believe that, and you're not ready to really believe that yet.
And that ties into intensity. What we were talking about before And your definition of intensity was great. I have a little bit of a different take on it. Intensity to me is exactly what you're saying right now. It's that taking every bit of mental acuity that you have and putting it into that movement you're about to do, whether it's a rep of concentration curls or a deadlift. Intensity is taking your entire being and putting it into every movement that you do every time you work out. I can see two people working out doing the same movements, and outwardly to someone else, it might look like they're doing the exact same thing, but I can tell this guy is truly putting the intensity of his mind to muscle communication into this, and this guy's just going through the motions. And there's a huge difference in results.